If you're wondering, why do I feel nauseous after ketamine treatment, you're watching the right video. Today, I'm going to share with you why you might be nauseous. Plus, if you stay till the very end, I'm going to share some options that you can discuss with your ketamine specialist. Hi, I'm Dr. Go from Reset Ketamine in Palm Springs, California. So why are you feeling nauseous? There's a few things to consider. Number one, ketamine can sometimes stimulate the vestibular system. That's part of our brain that's kind of like the gyroscope that allows us to have some balance. One of the things that we've noticed is patients may report feeling dizzy. And this is because mainly the vestibular system is affected by ketamine therapy. So one of the things that we'll see on a patient is something called nystagmus, and that's where the eyes are literally kind of shifting back and forth, and that can be seen during the dissociated and subdissociative states. The second thing is we know that ketamine works on multiple receptors, predominantly one called the NMDA and methyl-D-aspartate receptor. However, ketamine also impacts the dopamine receptors as well as the serotonin receptor. When those receptors are stimulated, they can frequently cause nausea. Accordingly, we have met various medications that can help prevent that, and I'm going to get to that in the end. The other thing to consider is the gut-brain connection. I don't know if you knew this, but the enteric nervous system, which is the nervous system of the brain, as well as the central nervous system, come from the same embryonic fetal origin. Literally, they come from the neural crest cells when we are developing in utero. What that means is a lot of the receptors that are in the brain also are inside of our intestinal system. So we'll typically see some patients who take various antidepressants and other psychiatric medications, well, we'll notice that it also affects their gut. As one example, think about irritable bowel syndrome, IBS. Sometimes that is frequently occurring with such states such as anxiety and depression. The last component to consider is maybe even a spiritual or energetic connection with nausea. One of the things I've noticed is sometimes when a patient is thinking about something, maybe a remote history of trauma or some other adverse effect experience in their life, they may feel nauseous. You know, they'll say, I feel sick to my stomach thinking about that individual or thinking about that incident. Well, it's because there is this connection between the psyche and the gut. Now, let's consider some options that I personally suggest for our patients. Number one is fasting prior to the ketamine infusion. This is really good because it'll be an empty stomach, meaning less likely to develop nausea. Also, ketamine can be potentially relaxing the esophageal sphincter, which will allow food contents to come from the stomach and into the throat, causing aspiration. So it's really crucial to fast prior to the ketamine infusion. We also have various medications. One of the classic ones is called Zofran, also known as ondansetron. If you think about the mechanism of action of this medication, it's actually affecting the serotonin receptor. It's a serotonin receptor antagonist. So since we know that ketamine can potentially stimulate the serotonin receptor, we can use medications to block that activity. Another medication we use is called Reglan, and Reglan can actually stimulate and block the dopamine from activating the dopamine receptors. So again, as mentioned earlier, ketamine can stimulate dopamine receptors, so we can block activity of that using the medicine called Reglan. Finally, there's another medicine called meclizine, also known as antivert, and that's kind of a gentle anticholinergic, which will help reduce stimulation of that vestibular system that I had mentioned earlier. It's classically a medication used for like motion sickness. I think it's called Bonine, over-the-counter available. So that is another medicine, meclizine, that can be used. I hope you found this information useful, and I will see you in the next video.